about this combination lock?
What kind of code would he use?
It would use either your... the year you were born. I keep forgetting.
Yes!
Oh, I just passed by it. It automatically selected. Firecrackers.
Thanks for storing my explosives, Chief.
Yeah.
Now I'm ready to rock. Sorry, Dad.
Huh? Not that sorry. Binder? Oh. Here's where it is. Police are seeking witnesses to a fatal hit and run that occurred on December 16, 2014 at 7:15 p.m. Tuesday night on Mantle Street and Asteroid Drive. Right. That's what the private investigator was investigating. Trying to get surveillance footage. Oh no, it wasn't the investigator, it was the other people. Department of Highways or something like that. They wouldn't give him the surveillance footage. The victim, identified as Emily Erickson, 28, of Beaver Creek, Oregon, was apparently walking from her stranded car when she was struck head-on by an unidentified speeding vehicle. She is survived by a husband and son who were not on the scene at the time. Captain Anderson says that the toll cameras may hold important clues. We're treating this as a case of vehicular homicide. Anybody with information regarding the incident should call the anonymous Beaver Creek Police hotline at 555-CAPTURE. Alright, so this might be for the cell phone lock code. Could be 12/16/2014. Maybe 7:15 p.m. Only 28, wow.
I know Dad spent a lot of money on the funeral. Oh.
Yeah. In loving memory of Emily Erickson. Emily Erickson, 28, beloved wife, mother, and daughter, departed our world far too soon on December 16th. Right, same date. 2014 in Beaver Creek, Oregon. Emily was born in Eugene, Oregon on January 25th, 1986 to Peter and Kristen Wyatt. Right, Peter is when that letter's from. Grandparents. Alright, so born. That could be it also. 1/25/1986. A passionate artist since kindergarten, she was near the top of her class at Eugene High School, winning various local art competitions and a prize scholarship to the prestigious Blackwell Academy in Arcadia Bay, Oregon. Again, a reference to the Blackwell Academy as seen in the first, well, Life is Strange and Life is Strange Before the Storm. After graduation, she went back to Eugene and married her college sweetheart, Charles Erickson, on May 1st, 2006. Look at that. These are all possibilities. May 1st, 2006. Emily and Charles moved to Beaver Creek, Oregon in 2007, where she later began a rewarding career teaching kindergarten and inspiring young people in the arts. Emily and Charles are also blessed with a wonderful son, Chris, born on February 8th, 2007. 2/8/2007. And they weren't wasting no time there. Emily's honest and humorous online comic strips about her family's life brought her humble recognition. She is survived by her husband Charles, their son Chris, and her parents Peter and Kristen. Funeral services are planned for 12 p.m. December 20th at Eugene Willow Hill Cemetery with a reception to follow. Friends and family are welcome and encouraged to pay their last respects. Now, it could be the funeral date, but I doubt that. Grandparents' letter. That's it, huh?
Grandma and Grandpa were so nice. I wish we saw them more.
That's a scrawly handwriting there. Dear Charles, thank you for your lovely note and flowers for Kristen's birthday. They always mean more coming from you. We miss you and would love to see how Chris is growing. Like you, we also still miss Emily every day, every hour and minute, and we know that grief is part of your life. So always know that we think of you often. And we're always here for you, like you were there for us, forever. Please stay in touch and let's make plans to meet soon. Your family and always in our hearts and prayers. Love, Peter. Why do you throw these letters in here? Okay. So we got the thing. I think maybe the fireworks are what we need to blow up the snowman. Blow up. Is that an M80?
Now you are ready to battle with Captain Spirit.
Yeah, I think he's got a handicap fighting you with that stuck in him.
Yes! So cool!
Snowmancer almost froze the whole city. Until Captain Spirit melted him. For now.
It looks like there's a cigarette in there, too. No. Yeah. You stick the cigarettes in there, too? One cigarette that he stole. We still need to do that. Full costume. Well, I don't think Snowmancer will be bothering the town again. I don't remember seeing this. The shark stinger? Wait.
Here comes the shark stinger.
Indeed. Oh, we accomplished something? Hold on. There's a basketball there too. I don't think I looked at that.
Ooh, the shark stinger is looking for victims.
It has found your foot.
Look out! Here comes the evil car!
That pedestrian better get out of the way.
With a voice like that, he deserves to die. Do nothing.
No!
How can you run over innocent people? Nobody should die like that. Mantroid and his minions will pay for this.
Can I play again and select the other option? Oh, I can't even look at it at all. Okay. I can look at these. Yeah, look at that. Whoa, now that is an epic super battle. Maybe the spaceship is the car. And if it did start the car. Okay. We're gonna go for a little joyride because Dad is out sleeping.
Here I come, Mantroid.
Come on, let's get going. This is Captain Spirit. You copy? Are you there, Sky Pirate? Captain Spirit, I read you loud and clear. Are you sure you want to go on this dangerous mission? Don't worry about me. Mantroid is the one in danger. Gotta do a quick system check first.
You're confident, aren't you?
Instrument panel, check. Force field, check. Proton missiles, check. Escape pod, check. Windshield wipers, check. Everything looks good. Start the launch. We're going faster than light speed. What's that ahead? Oh no! Meteor shower! Turn on the force field!
This is not a black hole.
Too late! Emergency! That SOS! Crash landing!
Ah! Imagine he crashed the car for real.
I wonder how many ships Mantroid has crashed on this planet. Never mind. I landed safe. Time to explore!
Oh, here we are again.
The planet is so dark, and the sky is so red, like blood. No wonder Mantroid lives here.
It's the blood of his victims.
But how could anyone live here? It's kind of sad and lonely.
Maybe he's undead. Doesn't have to live there. He just exists there. What do I do now? I run. I can't run.
What's that sound?
It's a monster.
Something is coming. Or somebody.
The only nearby thing to look at is this. I dare very much.
Mantroid, show yourself, you coward!
Yeah, not showing himself. Okay. Just think, I would have missed all this. Because it's gonna take us forever to get over there. Is that Marauder Shields over there? Marauder Shields, save us! It's a slower than that walk. Or crawl. That's just Dad talking when he's drunk. Next time we'll just whoop him upside the head.
Oh. This time, you won't get away from me.
Don't answer to the name Captain Idiot.
I don't have to get away because I'm everywhere.
Okay.
Fight me instead of hiding.
Can we, speed this up a little? Look, regular ground. You can walk faster here. That's just switching the camera. What's that street sign? It's apocalyptic Earth. Ghosties?
I'm bored now. Let's finish this.
No! I can't let you live.
Oh, jeez. Mash. I'm holding it. Am I supposed to hold it or mash it? I'm supposed to hold it. Or maybe I'm supposed to mash it. Oh well, I'm not doing that all that over again.
You will pay for what you did, Mantroid. I swear.
I know. We'll click the mouse better next time. Alright, we just gotta get... Okay, Mantroid, I swear this is the last time you slip away from Captain Spirit. So the last thing I have to do is this. Try using those codes. Okay. I tried all those dates and stuff. Nothing worked. I ended up looking up a walkthrough. Believe it or not, because I just want to see this. The last thing we have to do. You correspond the numbers that... you type in the letters that correspond to the numbers. Hot dog. So... yeah. It's H... A... W... T... D... A... W... G.
Yes! I can hack any system!
You say so.
Let's start.
Oh, cool.
Damn you, barbecue.
Haha. So, we can't even control the walking speed or anything like that. Like, he's pooping that out. Oh.
No.
That music sure is funny. Oops. Oh, crap.
Barbecue.
Oh, I missed the mushroom. Really? Got it. Wow.
No.
Do it. If I hold it down. Oh, that goes faster. There you go. I was like double clicking, triple, quadruple clicking and stuff.
Now I'm on fire.
Oh, I hit them. Coco. Press to mustard. We will muster our mustard. I got it on there.
Damn,
oh crap.
Barbecue. Man, I suck. Now I'm on fire.
I'm on fire. Yeah, I hope not literally. Ah! I got farther this time, though.
Thank you.
Oops. Oops.
Vultures suck.
Oh, that's what they are? Vultures? I killed myself trying to get that mustard packet. That one. Whoops, that was close. Ah. I should knock him out of the sky by doing that. You know, I'm thinking of a bit like Mario, where you can bump into things the right way, defeats them.
Need more points.
Ah! It goes up. Is that the real high score? It's still not beat. Oh yeah, I haven't been watching the numbers. Is that a timer or a score? Or both? It's a... The timer adds to the score. And the mustards give you more points. I got all three of them! I just want to beat the high score, really. That thing. Whoops. No! Oh, no, 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 no.
Crap.
Ah! We both said crap at the same time. I didn't beat the score. New high score! Wow.
Ah. No.
Well, beat the high score at least.
I would love to see Hot Dog Man team up with Captain Spirit.
I love you, Hot Dog Man. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in Life is Strange 2. Always, seek adventure.